Alright, so now the next thing that we do is we will perform a similar vertical and horizontal analysis for balance sheet. The procedure is exactly same. So I'm going to open up a new sheet. We would call this as vertical analysis balance sheet. Vertical analysis balance sheet. Alt WVG, we would get rid of the grid lines. Then we will go to balance sheet. Select the whole set of data as it is. Then go on to the vertical analysis format. First cell, Control V, then Control A, Alt HOI, Alt WFF to freeze panes, then delete all the amounts, we don't need them. Then again, the idea of vertical analysis is to see each item on your balance sheet as a proportion to total assets or total liabilities. So please observe the formula carefully. Is equal to, I have opened the formula in cell C5, which is a share capital. Then I'm going to go to balance sheet again in cell C5, which is 95.92 divided by the total of equity and liability, which is 4594. Now, when you copy paste this, you want that denominator always coming from row 21 because the total of asset and liability is same. So F4, we would do that twice and then copy and simply copy paste this formula. Across the region, wherever there were original numbers. So now we are getting everything as a percentage to total assets. All the items as a percentage to total assets. And then your vertical analysis of balance sheet is ready. Now once you've done this, is it done? So how do you read this number? Out of the total size of the balance sheet, about 25 or 26% is in tangible assets. Then a very large proportion is in current investment. Inventory 25%, almost 1/4 of total assets, 13% in trade receivables. So if you'd observe current assets, about 50% of the balance sheet is made of current assets. Okay, and therefore, when you're modeling, I think one important area for us to forecast would be what would be the size of inventory or current investments going forward. Are we together on this? The same intuition on the liability side, reserve surplus is about 50%. Long-term borrowing 1%, which means a debt-free company. So we don't really have to worry too much about that aspect of the organization. And then payables 18%, other current liability 12% here. So this is how you read vertical analysis, where it gives you every item as a percentage to total asset and total liability. And it just gives you a very quick insight into company in terms of how balance sheet is made of different components. Are we good with this? Let us prepare a horizontal analysis of balance sheet. The process would be exactly same. We would just copy paste the balance sheet and then we would put the first formula. Now in a horizontal balance sheet, what you need to do is you need to see year on year increase. So I am in D5 right now. I would say is equal to control page up so that we go to balance sheet. And once we've done control page up, then again D5 divided by C5. Now since we want to be able to copy paste this, no, we don't put any freeze, and then we would say -1, and this has given us an increase of almost 0 because the value is same. And then wherever this number is, we will just copy paste the formula. So I'm copy pasting formulas everywhere, and then we will fix the formatting. And whenever you don't have values, just delete those sections. Okay, we don't want anything in the first row, so I'm going to delete all the values there, and your horizontal balance sheet analysis is ready. Okay, you can go to any cell and check if the logic is correct. If you are in the G cell, in the 10th cell, then the formula should be G10, which is value of this year, divided by F10, which is value of last year, -1. And let's look at some of the values. There is no trend per se or nothing insightful when it comes to reserves and surplus. The most important component you would see is the value of payables. It was growing by 7%, then 12%. But last year there is a decrease of 11% on a year-on-year basis. And that is quite insightful because you ideally would want payable values to be lower. Then let's look at the tangible assets value. And this is quite surprising. You would expect company to have a large amount of positive capex, and therefore every year you would expect these values to increase. But if you would observe here, there is almost 100% increase in FY 11-12. Let's confirm that by looking at the balance sheet. Okay, tangible assets, and we can see that tangible assets in 11-12 were 1200 crores, and next year they became 2365 crores, almost double the amount, right? So this is the beauty of horizontal analysis. It gives you insights by, you can focus on the large numbers, and then surprisingly for the last 2 years, your value of tangible asset year on year growth is negative. Okay, so negative growth does not mean that company is selling the assets. What it means is every year there is depreciation, and the amount of new capex that the company has, that capex is less than the amount of depreciation, and therefore your total net value of asset is coming out to be lower. Are you following the intuition? But then for both of these years, we have a strong increase in intangible and we have a strong increase in work in progress. Okay, so we have to do some more analysis on this part, and then we would look at the current investment, inventories, trade receivables. Again, year on year, there is some decrease in the continuous decrease trend. Cash and bank balances have become, the year on year growth has become negative. And then other current assets, which is again, not very, there's no significant trend per se in this. Any questions?